Hi guys, so today we are starting with finance current affairs for RBI and SEBI exams for 2019. So the first question that follows is that ONGC, the country's largest oil and gas producer, completed the acquisition of government-owned fuel retailer HPCL. Which of the following is set up for achieving quick decisions involving strategic disinvestment? First option is Niti Aayog, second is Deepam. Third is AM. AM is basically alternative mechanism, and CPSE is Central Public Sector Enterprises. So firstly, we'll try to understand that what strategic disinvestment is. So strategic disinvestment, according to Deepam. Now what is Deepam? Deepam is Department of Investment and Public Asset Management. So according to Deepam, there may be two types of strategic disinvestment. In the first one, it says the transfer of block of shares to a strategic partner. So complete shareholding is when transferred to another strategic partner, that constitutes strategic disinvestment. And the another form is when the transfer of management control to a strategic partner. So what does the implication says that after the transaction, so here only the management control is transferred, and so the implication here says that the strategic partner may hold less percentage of the shares than the one who is selling it, but the control of management would be with the strategic partner itself. So basically, if a government is selling, is doing strategic disinvestment for some of its PSUs, so the strategic partner may choose to hold less percentage of share than the government, and but it does have the control of management, does have the management control with it. So this type of arrangement is also included in strategic disinvestment. So the definition here says strategic disinvestment would imply the sale of substantial portion of the government shareholding of a central public sector enterprise of up to 50% or such higher percentage as the competent authority may determine, along with the transfer of management control. So this definition has already been discussed here in two points, that transfer of block of shareholding or only the transfer of management control to a strategic partner. So in this mechanism, the percentage shareholding doesn't matter because the management control is with the strategic partner. So moving further, the big shift is, firstly, earlier the government used to do strategic disinvestment for its PSUs, only the loss-making central public sector enterprises. But now the government have changed its view regarding the same. It now privatizes or strategically disinvest profit-making state-run companies also. So from the loss-making to the profit-making, the government has done a big shift regarding this. So now, why strategic disinvestment? Why the government enters into the mechanism of strategic disinvestment? The question arises here. So the basic economic principle which says is that government wants good for all for its economy. So government should not enter the business, or it does not want to enter into a business where there is already competition. And second reason is economic potential of such entities may be discovered in the hands of new strategic partners. The government may be inefficient in running those PSUs. So that is why the government may enter into strategic disinvestment to have economic potential. Now what economic potential means? It means to improve the functional and the financial efficiency. So to improve functional financial efficiencies of its PSUs, the government may enter into strategically disinvestment. Now, Deepam's agenda. So Deepam's agenda says that not only the strategic disinvestment means to sell the stake of shares to a private company or to another strategic partner, but strategic disinvestment also means the merger, the consolidation, or the acquisition. So as we have seen in the case ONGC and HPCL, So in ONGC has acquired HPCL's share. It has a major shareholding in HPCL and both are PSUs. So mergers and acquisitions and consolidation of two PSUs is also constituted by strategic disinvestment. So continuing with the same, consolidation is done basically because of the synergies that underlies with both the PSUs. So the synergies are then combined to create a larger PSU and to make a good move in the economy. So NBCC is basically a construction and project company consultancy PSU, and it is going to buy four companies, and all of these four are PSUs. So first is Hindustan Prefab Limited, second is Engineering Project Limited, then HSCC, which is the healthcare infrastructure, and NPCC is engaged in irrigation hydel projects. So as you can see that NBCC, which is a construction and project management consultancy, is entering into a consolidation kind of a thing, is entering into a acquisition kind of a thing to make a bigger PSU and to have a strong footing in the economy. So making it a suitable option, how one PSU is acquiring another PSU. What is the attraction point over here? How does one PSU is enticed to acquire another PSU? So companies such as Scooters India, India Drug and Pharmaceuticals, and many other companies are also there which have big assets with them, and by acquiring the PSUs, another PSU, the PSU which is acquiring them may get hold of such assets which may help in stronger business opportunities. So as we can see that Scooters, Indian Drug and Pharmaceuticals and a few others are sitting on huge tracts of land which can be used by cash rich PSUs. So basically government has now planned to consolidate, to disinvest, basically strategically disinvest 21 PSUs. And out of those 21 PSUs, these two PSUs are also there and these four PSUs are also there. So there is a list of 21 PSUs which the government want to strategically disinvest. Now there are various methods of strategic disinvestments of CPSEs. CPSEs is basically Central Public Sector Enterprises. So first is the IPO. So as we know that IPO is basically selling shares for the first time in the market. Then we have share buyback. Share buybacks is basically the reacquisition by a company of its own stock. So when a company basically buybacks its own stock, reacquire its own stock from the market. Then we have further public offering. So further public offering is basically when the shares offered for sale for the second, third or fourth time is called FPO. FPO is also known as follow public offering. Then fourth, we have offer for sale. So offer for sale means where the promoters sell their shares directly to the public in a transparent manner. So here the promoters in public company can sell their shares and reduce their holdings from public listed company easily. Next, we have CPSE exchange traded fund. So CPSE exchange traded fund is basically an open-ended index exchange traded scheme. So what basically CPSE ETFs is? So it is basically a concentrated portfolio of PSU stocks whose objective is to help the government in disinvesting its stock in a few CPSE via ETF route. And we know what ETF is. ETF is exchange traded fund, and it is basically the collection of securities. It is the collection of securities that tracks an underlying index. Underlying index. So these are the five methods for strategic disinvestment of CPSEs. So by any of the method, a government could disinvest, a PSU could disinvest. And as we have discussed earlier also, consolidation, mergers and acquisitions are also a part of this strategic disinvestment method. Then tell me more. So basically, target for 2019-20 is that government is hoping to disinvest its 21 PSUs and to have 90,000 crore rupees from the dilution of its stake in central PSUs. So it's basically fundraising mechanism for the government by strategically disinvesting its PSUs. Second point here is that recent changes in March 2019 indicates that there is a formation of alternative mechanism. Alternative mechanism is AM. So AM is formed and it is led by finance minister. It is led by road minister, who is currently Nitin Gadkari, and minister representing the administrative department concerned. So only three people are involved in this mechanism. Then why is AM formed? It is to speed up the strategic sales, because earlier the strategic disinvestment process was a lengthy one and it continued for days and weeks and months. So to speed up the mechanism, to settle down everything, to settle the PSUs, AM is formed to speed up the strategic sales. Then we have many functions are diluted or many functions have been delegated to AM. So quantity of shares sold, mode of sale, final pricing of transactions. So as I have told you that settlement is being done by AM, and AM replaces GOM, which is the Now we have Niti Aayog draw up the list of non-core assets owned by CPSEs, and the report Niti Aayog will be taken up by the alternative mechanism on disinvestment. So Niti Aayog will basically prepare a report that which strategic partners, which PSUs have to be considered for strategic disinvestment, and this report will then be taken up by the alternative mechanism for the speedy process. So coming back to the question again, ONGC, the country's largest oil and gas producer, completed the acquisition of government-owned fuel retailer HPCL. Which of the following is set up for achieving quick decisions involving strategic disinvestment? So we know that Niti Aayog just prepares the report on the PSUs, for the PSUs that have to be strategically disinvested. We know DIPAM is the department here, and under this department everything is happening. We know that AM in the recent changes, that is alternative mechanism, in the recent changes have been formed for the quick decisions, for the speedy process of strategic disinvestment. And we know that CPSE is there, that is central public sector enterprise is there, which has nothing to do with the quick decisions involving strategic disinvestment. So the answer here is option number C. So with this, we have completed this question and the concept of strategic disinvestment thoroughly.